So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session guys without any delay. But before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon if you are coming here for the first time, and you can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed, and you can also ask your doubts here. You can also follow me on Instagram. Here also you can ask anything related to examinations. So let's talk about the very first question, which is very important question based on a scheme. Consider the following statement with respect to scheme on enhancement of competitiveness in capital goods sector. Capital goods sector ko basically enhance karne ke liye ye scheme launch ki gayi hai. And you have to identify the correct statement. Alright, so let's talk about the scheme guys. So remember, this is not a new scheme. Right now its phase 2 has been launched. Iska phase 2 launch hua hai. Its phase 1 was launched in the year 2014. 2014 mein iska phase 1 notify ho gaya tha. Alright. So the Ministry of Heavy Industries has notified the scheme on enhancement of competitiveness in capital goods sector phase 2. And remember, who is the Minister of Heavy Industry? Mr. Mahendra Nath Pandey, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Chandauli, which is in Uttar Pradesh. Now, this scheme has the objective to provide assistance to common technology development and service infrastructure. Jo technology development or service infrastructure hai, usko assistance provide karana is the basic objective of this particular scheme or iska phase 2. Now, talking about the scheme, so if I talk about the objective in detail, so the broad objective of this scheme is to create a strong and globally competitive capital goods sector that will contribute at least 25% to the manufacturing sector of the country. And this number one objective is the most important objective. Yahi aapko yaad rakhna hai. Iske alawa jo baaki do hai, these are just the supportive objectives. Number two is to create a self-sustaining ecosystem for research and innovation for manufacturing technologies. And number three, providing infrastructure for testing quality of processes. So these are the three broad objectives of this particular scheme, and ye wala objective aapko yaad rakhna hai, this is very important. Ministry of course is Ministry of Heavy Industries. Now earlier it was Ministry of Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises, alright. But very recently the Department of Public Enterprises was transferred to Ministry of Finance, okay, and that's why this ministry is now just Ministry of Heavy Industries. The scheme was launched in the year 2014, which means its phase 1 was launched in the year 2014, and now its phase 2 has been launched in the year 2022. The total financial outlay guys of phase 2 is rupees 1207 crores, and out of this 1207 crores, rupees 975 crore will come from the budgetary support and rupees 230 crore will come from the industries, okay. And there are 6 components of this particular scheme. Yes, in components ki detail mein jaane ki zarurat nahi hai. We don't have to go into the details of these components. Just remember that there are 6 components under this particular scheme, which are identification of technologies through technology innovation portal, scheme on enhancement of competitiveness in capital goods sector, promotion of skilling in capital goods sector, creation of qualification packages for skills level 6 and above, setting up of 4 common engineering facility centers and augmentations of existing ones, augmentation of existing testing and certification centers, and setting up of 10 industry accelerators for technology development. Ye sab kuch yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai, ye ek bar read kar liya abhi aapne, that is more than enough. Aur ek bar jab PDF pad rahe hoge, then read it once more. Alright, that will be enough. So that's it about the scheme guys, and now let's come back to the question. So we have to identify the correct statement. Its phase 1 was launched in the year 2017. No, that's incorrect. Phase 1 was launched in the year 2014. Total outlay for second phase is not 1000 crore, it's 1207 crores. Alright, so this is incorrect also, and it will be implemented by Ministry of Finance. Nahi. It will be implemented by Ministry of Heavy Industries, headed by Mr. Mahendra Nath Pandey. So all the statements are incorrect, which means option D will be the correct answer. So I hope guys this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. With which of the following organizations, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched Swachhta Startup Challenge? So this is a new challenge launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, headed by Hardeep Singh Puri, who is also the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Now let's talk about this. So remember, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs along with DPIIT, which is Department for Promotion of Industries and Internal Trade, and a French agency AFD, which is Agency Franchise de Development. अब देखो मेरे को फ्रेंच तो आती नहीं है, तो इसकी क्या प्रोनाउंसिएशन होगी आप ज्यादा अच्छे से जानते हो अगर आपको फ्रेंच आती है तो. सो हम AFD ही पढ़ेंगे. Has launched the स्वच्छता स्टार्टअप चैलेंज. सो दिस चैलेंज गाइज हैज बीन लॉन्च टू प्रोवाइड एन इम्पीटस टू स्टार्टअप्स. सो नाम से ही पता चल रहा है स्टार्टअप है, स्वच्छता है, विच मीन्स दिस चैलेंज विल डेफिनेटली टॉक अबाउट द वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट सेक्टर एंड द स्टार्टअप्स. सो इट हैज बीन लॉन्च टू प्रोवाइड एन इम्पीटस टू स्टार्टअप्स फॉर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ सैनिटेशन एंड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट सेक्टर ऑफ इंडिया. ऑलराइट, रिमेंबर इट हैज बीन लॉन्च अंडर द स्वच्छ भारत मिशन अर्बन 2.0. सो वी ऑल नो दैट द सेकेंड edition of Swachh Bharat Mission Urban is going on, and under this particular mission this challenge has been launched. This challenge is focused on four thematic areas, which are social inclusion, zero dump, plastic waste management, and transparency through digital enablement. All right, and the top 10 awardees will receive 25 lakhs along with 1 year incubation support from the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So now let's come back to the question. We have to identify the organization. So that's DPIIT. Option A will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 3, guys. To disseminate the information about all the NIPERs and their research activities, NIPER research portal has been launched. So the question is, who has launched the portal? Kisne launch kiya hai? So remember, Minister of Chemicals and Fertilizers, who is of course also the Minister of Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Mansukh Mandavia, has launched NIPER research portal, which is National Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research. NIPER stands for National Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research. Remember, this portal will disseminate the information about all the NIPERs in the country and whatever they are doing in the research areas, whatever patents they have filed and whatever publication information, all these things will be provided through this portal. And it will definitely help other researchers and especially the industries to get in touch with the relevant organization. All right. Now, talking about these NIPERs, guys. So remember, they are a set of national level institutions in the area of pharma research, pharmaceutical research. Mein ye set of institution, and they have been awarded the status of institution of national importance by the government of India, and they work under the Department of Pharmaceuticals. Department of Pharmaceuticals under the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, headed by Mansukh Mandavia. The very first NIPER was established in Mohali in the year 1998, and currently there are 7 NIPERs which are operating in the country. One at Mohali, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Guwahati, Hajipur, Ahmedabad, and one more is in Rai Bareli. So these are the 7 NIPERs which are operating currently in the country. Alright. So who has launched this portal, by the way? So it's Dr. Mansukh Mandavia. Option A will be the correct answer. Now let's talk about question number 4. Which of the following has become the first ministry amongst all the ministries and departments to come up with a capacity building plan under Mission Karma Yogi? Now first of all, let's talk about the Mission Karma Yogi. Then we will come back to the news. So remember, Mission Karma Yogi, it is nothing but a national program on capacity building of civil services. National program on capacity building of civil services, which is also known as Mission Karma Yogi. It was launched in the year 2020 for individual and institutional capacity buildings of the civil services. Alright, the tenure of this mission, guys, is 5 years. Total outlay is rupees 510 crores. And it is estimated that around 46 lakh central employees will be trained under this particular mission. And two important organizations have been set up under this mission, which is, number one is Public Human Resource Council, headed by the Prime Minister of India. It approves the capacity building plan. It has the responsibility of approving the capacity building plan presented by any department or ministry. And one, we have Capacity Building Commission, which has the responsibility of monitoring and implementing those capacity building plans. Okay, so now let's talk about the news. So remember, Minister of Food Processing Industry Pashupati Paras has released the vision document of capacity building plan of the ministry under the Mission Karma Yogi. And after this, Ministry of Food Processing Industry has become the very first ministry among all the ministries and departments to come up with this plan. Remember, This document has been developed with the support of Capacity Building Commission constituted under the mission Karma Yogi, and it will definitely enable employees to be more creative, proactive, professional, technology enabled, etc. Alright, so this was about this news, and that's why guys, the correct answer will be what? Option D, Ministry of Food Processing Industry headed by Pashupati Paras. Okay. Now, let's talk about the question number 5. With which of the following power companies Goa Shipyard Limited has signed an MOU for setting up of rooftop solar power projects? So remember, this MOU guys has been signed with IREDA, Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency. Option A is the correct answer. IREDA, remember, it is a PSU under the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, while Goa Shipyard Limited is a PSU under Ministry of Defense, headed by Mr. Rajnath Singh, and this ministry is headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. And of course, the Ministry of India, the Government of India has set a target of 40 gigawatt of solar energy by rooftop solar plants. ठीक है, 40 gigawatt solar energy through rooftop solar plants by the end of 2022. It is the target of Government of India. So option A, IREDA, is the correct answer. All right. So guys, that's it for session today. And as you all know, कल budget आने वाला है. So कल तैयार रहना, get ready tomorrow. कल शाम को ही session हो जाएगा. And मैं थोड़ा सा time लेता हूँ budget बनाने में, because मैंने देखा है कई channels के ऊपर कि क्या होता है कि पहले वीडियो बनाने के चक्कर में बहुत कई चीज़ें जो है वो छोड़ देते हैं. तो अगर आप देखना चाहते हो कि मैं कैसे बजट पेश करता हूँ आपके सामने, तो आप पिछले साल वाला सेशन देख सकते हो. ठीक है, तो कल शाम को सेशन होगा बजट का. ठीक है, तो मिलते हैं कल शाम को बजट के सेशन में. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. बाय बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.